बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू टेक्निकली एक्सप्लेन्ड। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द यूनिट इंपल्स सिग्नल। द यूनिट इंपल्स सिग्नल इज आल्सो कॉल्ड द डायरेक्ट डेल्टा सिग्नल एंड इट इज डिनोटेड बाय डेल्टा ऑफ टी। एंड दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द यूनिट इंपल्स सिग्नल। एट टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो वी हैव सम इनफाइनाइट वैल्यू एंड वी हैव जीरो वैल्यूज अदरवाइज। द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ दिस यूनिट इंपल्स सिग्नल इज दैट द एरिया ऑफ द कर्व अंडर कर्व ऑफ दिस यूनिट इंपल्स सिग्नल इज इक्वल टू वन। That is why it is called the unit impulse signal. We have a term unit over here. So the area under curve of this signal is equal to 1. And we can visualize the signal by considering a rectangular signal. For example, I have a rectangular signal whose width varies from minus epsilon to plus epsilon, where epsilon is some constant. So the total width here is going to be 2 epsilon. Now the area, because the area under curve of the impulse signal is 1, so this height is going to be equal to 1 by 2 epsilon e. Now if I decrease the width of this rectangular pulse, for example, if I decrease the width to say minus epsilon by 2 to epsilon by 2, that is the total width now becomes, the total width now becomes epsilon. This width now becomes epsilon. So now the height is going to be equal to 1 by epsilon to get the area of 1. So if I am decreasing the width of this rectangular pulse, the height is going to increase. Finally, as the width of this rectangular pulse reaches zero, that is if I further decrease the width of this rectangular pulse and it becomes very small, that it approaches to zero, the height is going to increase further and further until the height is going to approach to infinite. Now when the height approaches to infinite and we have a very small width, that signal is called the impulse signal. So in impulse signal, basically we have a signal like this whose width is very small and whose height is very large and it approaches towards the infinity. So this is actually my impulse signal. Now we can define the impulse signal as the unit impulse signal as delta of t is equal to 1 for t is equal to 0 and it is 0 otherwise. So the unit impulse signal is going to have a magnitude of 1 at t is equal to 0 and at other values it is going to have a 0 value. So if I want to plot this unit impulse signal, I can simply plot this by considering an impulse over here. So this is going to be my impulse and this is going to be at t is equal to 0. This is my t axis. This is my amplitude. So this is my delta of t signal, which is the unit impulse signal, which has the magnitude of 1 at t is equal to 0 and it is 0 otherwise. Now there are some important properties of the impulse signal, but before discussing the important properties, we need to study the general expression of the impulse signal. So I'm going to write general expression of impulse signal. The general expression of impulse signal can be written as x of t is equal to k, where k is some magnitude, delta of t minus t naught. So this is the general expression of the impulse signal, where k is the magnitude or the amplitude. K is the magnitude or the amplitude. It can be negative or positive values. And this t minus t naught, this t naught, actually this impulse signal is shifted by t naught. For example, if I have a signal which is, for example, say x of t is equal to 10 delta of t minus 9. So now this is a shifted impulse signal whose amplitude is 10. So I am going to plot this by saying that at t is equal to, this is my t. So at t is equal to 9, I am going to have a signal. For example, this is my 0, this is my y-axis and this is my x-axis, which is t. So at t is equal to 9, I am going to have the amplitude of this signal, which is 10. So in this way, I can plot this signal in this way. Similarly, if I have x of t is equal to 3 delta of t plus 3, I can also plot this. I can plot this by, because this is t plus 3, so it means that we are going to have an impulse signal at minus 3. So this is because we are going to equate this to 0. T plus 3 is equal to 0, which means t is equal to minus 3. So we are going to have an impulse signal at t is equal to minus 3, and the magnitude of that impulse is going to be 3. So this is how we can plot the signal. Now there are important properties of the impulse signal. First property is that impulse signal is an even signal. So delta of t is equal to delta of minus t. The second property that we already studied, that the area under curve of the impulse signal is going to be equal to 1. So the area under curve of the impulse signal is going to be equal to 1. The third property is a very important property, and it is also called the shifting property or sampling property. If we have integration from say B to A and we have some impulse signal, let me write the general expression of the impulse signal, and we have another function f of t. So the result of this function is going to be equal to k, which is the amplitude, k into f of t naught, provided that this t naught is in between A and B. And we can also simplify this by saying that if we have, for example, B of A or A anything, if we have, for example, k into delta of t into f of t dt, then this will be equal to f of 0, because in this case delta of t exists at f is equal to 0. So then from there we are going to get k into f of 0. Now what does this equation suggest? This suggests that, let me write over here, the product of any function, that is the f of t, the product of any function with impulse function, this is my impulse function, so the product of any function f of t with the impulse function is equal to the value of that function, at point where the impulse function exists. So if we can have a look, this is my impulse signal and this signal exists at t naught. So that is why we have multiplied the impulse signal with another function, and the product results into the value of that function at a point where impulse signal exists. Because the impulse signal exists as at t naught, that is why at here we have a t naught over here. Okay, the condition is that provided that that function is continuous, at point where impulse exists, So if you multiply any impulse function with any function, that will be equal to the value of that function at point where the impulse function exists. For example, here the impulse function exists at 0. This is delta of t, and delta of t is 1 for t is equal to 0. That is why here we have the impulse function exists at 0. That is why in answer we are going to have the value of that function at a point where the impulse function exists, that is at t is equal to 0. So this property is a very important property, and this is called the shifting property or the sampling property. For example, if we are given to calculate 0 to 5 sine 10, and we have the impulse signal at 3 and sine 100 of t dt. Now we can easily calculate using this formula. Now this function is going to be the value at f of 3. So this is my constant. I am going to write this constant. Here I have k is equal to 10. Here k is equal to 10, and this is my impulse signal and this is my function. So this will be equal to 10, and the value of that function, the impulse function exists at t is equal to 3. So I am going to put t is equal to 3 over here. So sine 100 into 3. This means that 10 into sine 300. This is an example of this प्रॉपर्टी।